Sometimes Christians argue that, you know what, I believe in God. I know he exists because I feel him in my heart. Just like, you know, your spouse exists, I know God exists. And I just want to say, I used to be a born-again believer. I used to think that I was led by God and could feel God. And now I'm just convinced it must be a delusion because it doesn't make sense logically. So that's where I'm at. What do you have to say about that?
Well, we'll find out Judgment Day. I'll stand next to you.
So do you think that feeling the presence of God is a good argument for the existence of God?
Well, I don't know. I don't ever use that one, but it is interesting to think about. I mean, I talk to him all the time. I think I know him. I've been his child for 46 years. I feel like he's my friend. Yes, I think we have a relationship, and I don't think I'm delusional. I've got a reasonable IQ, and, you know, I read a lot, and I'm willing to listen to any arguments, but I know him. I've seen him do some pretty amazing things. I don't know that he's still in the miracle-working business like when Jesus was here, raising the dead and healing the sick, though some people believe that. I'm a little more on the skeptical side of that argument, but, yeah, I happen to know him personally.
Do you think
talk to him all the time.
Is there any possible way you could be deluded, such as, like, you know, if you looked in the desert and you saw a mirage? I mean, people really do see a mirage, but it's not real. Do you think there's a possibility? Is there any possibility, like even a half of a zillion of a percent, that your relationship with that you feel could be a delusion?
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah, I would always entertain that thought, and I'm willing to. You know, could I not really be married? Could I not really be sitting here? Well, yeah, of course, you know. And maybe some Christians would get mad at me for even saying that's a possibility. But sure, I would entertain that.
Are you open enough to evidence? Like, for example, if you saw evidence that Noah's Ark never happened, there was no worldwide flood, do you think it's possible that if you saw evidence, you can change your mind about that? Or are you just going to believe it no matter what?
Oh, well, no. How do you prove the non-existence of something? I mean,
well, what if I said, I mean, I can't give you the evidence, but what if you did see evidence? Would you be willing to say, okay, I guess it's not true because I see evidence now?
Well, you know, yeah, I'm always willing to examine the facts and go where the facts lead. So far, to me, all of the facts lead to the evidence that there was a flood. I mean, there's clams on top of Mount Everest.
The reason why I ask is because I was reviewing again this Ham and Bill Nye debate, and Ken Ham seemed to be saying, like, look, it's a fact, the flood happened, and we're trying to figure out how it happened, but that it happened is a fact, and that's never going to change, kind of thing. So,
well, I do come from the position that I'm going to believe God's word until it is proven wrong, rather than I'm going to doubt the word until it's proven true, which seems to be your position.
No, I tried to believe it as long as I could, and I said, come on, God, just give me one thread, and I'll stay if I could, but I couldn't find one thread, so that's why I had to leave.
I guess I found plenty of them. Maybe you were looking under the wrong rock.